Hello, I'm Tamela Johnson, principal at St. Paul's Lutheran School here in Waverly, Iowa. Welcome to the Fruit of the Spirit, Return to Learn, Part 2. The fruit of the Holy Spirit is a biblical term that sums up 9 attributes of living in accordance with the Holy Spirit, according to chapter 5 of Galatians. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. As I think about our return to learn, it takes a combination of all these to help set us up for success with a focus on patience as we rely on the Iowa Department of Education, Public Health, Waverly Shellrock Schools, our school board, and especially God's guidance to help us draft a plan for optimal learning with a focus on health and safety. Last week, I outlined the components of our return to learn, focused on infrastructure, leadership, Iowa academic standards, equity and data considerations, technology and distance learning, health and safety, and social, emotional, and behavioral mental health. At St. Paul's Lutheran Church and School, we continue our conversations and planning around these big buckets. At St. Paul's, we've set 3 overarching goals for the 2021 school year, all focused on precaution, preparation, patience, and prayer, with the ultimate goal of returning this fall with all our students on site at the school. Our return to learn goal number 1 is to provide a seamless transition between in-person and remote learning and teaching. St. Paul's return to learn goal number 2 is focused on enhancing in-person, remote, and hybrid learning through the implementation of technology tools to engage, formally assess, encourage collaboration, enhance video conferencing, and develop a platform for communicating assignments, etc. Our return to learn goal number 3 would be to identify curriculum content, skills, standards that were not taught due to school closure and voluntary learning. Develop a plan to determine if in the fall the perceived gaps are actual gaps and create an action plan to address those gaps. This week, in our Fruit of the Spirit session, I'll focus on the beginnings of our plan for technology and distance learning. During the July school board meeting, board members emphasized the importance of goal number 1, a seamless transition between home and school instruction and learning. That is set a focus on ensuring that students have the technology tools they need to make that happen, and we are developing a plan to do just that. The board is excited to announce that beginning this fall, all students in grades K through 6 will be provided with a one-to-one device. The teachers will work together to outline their plans for usage during remote and on-site learning opportunities. Along with this objective, the school board has implemented an annual $20 technology fee for K-6 students to help cover repairs and replacement expenses. Creating that seamless transition between on-site learning with safety precautions, a hybrid, or through remote learning is the true challenge for all our staff. What tools and resources we utilize at home are also ones that we need to utilize in school to prepare for learning at home if another outbreak occurs and we are required to stay home. Our prayers continue that we can begin the school year in person and develop that sense of classroom community. So if we are directed by public health or the Department of Education to return home to learn, we are already connected and students are familiar with the tools that we will be utilizing. One thing that time gives us is the ability to plan and prepare. Last week, along with meeting with Waverly Public, I met with each of the teachers and the paraeducators. The staff had the opportunity to ask questions, express their concerns, and help determine their willingness to return. The staff is 100% in favor of returning with all students at school, but of course with safety precautions in place, which will be my focus on next week's Fruit of the Spirit. Whether at home or in school, how we use technology for in-school learning or for distance learning, we are developing a plan of action to ensure that the staff has the skills to instruct online as well as the tools to make that happen. This summer, the Department of Education announced that any teachers teaching online must have some professional growth opportunities to learn how to best engage students as well as assess them remotely. Last spring, all of our St. Paul's teachers had a professional growth opportunity through the completion of 3 online teaching micro-credentials, which they will continue working on this summer and into the fall. These classes will help them to be aware of best practices of teaching online, as well as different ways to engage and assess the students, whether at home or in the classroom. One technology tool that the teachers utilized last spring for parents and students is the use of Bitmoji classrooms. These classrooms provided easier access to websites and other resources that are just a click away. The upper elementary will continue the use of Google Classroom for students to access information, with the ability to submit assignments and the teachers to provide feedback. Devin Whipperman, our Director of Information and Worship Technologies, is in the process of setting up web cameras in each classroom so that each day, each child has the opportunity for some live instruction. If for some reason they are homesick, the family determines that coming to school isn't an option, or if we were required to stay home due to a school shutdown due to an outbreak. What live instruction looks like at each level will be different and will be determined this fall. But it is important to our school that students get to see and hear from their teacher each day. We will be reaching out to parents soon to check on your child's status of access to the web and times of the day for learning to take place. We are also exploring and looking at websites and programs that will enhance our students' learning as well as monitoring the students' learning and progress. This coming school year will no doubt hold many challenges. As we prepare, we are taking precautions and we are asking for you for patience and prayer. Next week, I'll share with you some of our preparations as we take precautions for health and safety. Please join me in a moment of prayer. Lord, hear our prayer as you continue to guide our 2021 school year preparations. Provide us with patience and help us outline the steps toward precaution. As people of faith, we remain confident that you are with us to meet every one of those challenges. Guide us to continue to support one another as a school family through this time of trial. We need each other more than ever. Remember, as long as our hope is in God, hope cannot disappoint. Amen. Please do not hesitate to contact us with any questions or concerns as we prepare for the new school year. You have our prayers and gratitude. May God bless St. Paul's and may God bless the United States of America. Take care, stay safe, and we'll see you next week.